Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe our channel. Liberalism has finally gone too far in California. States beyond repair. The only thing still shining in California besides the sun is the tail lights on the cars as they speed over Interstate 10, Midwest and South to escape liberal politics and high taxes. Jason Mulberry. At one time, California was consecrated the nirvana for creative industries and new technology, a place where the dreams of the future were incubated. It was a marriage of historic Spanish and frontier cultures interwoven from its southern borders to the hills of Eureka that produced endless opportunity for all comers. It was the epicenter of the American dream. A place where the sun rays shined on wealth and innovation. It was a haven for inventors, and those seeking their dreams of fortune and fame on stage and in movies. It was where the first TV station was born, KTLA Channel 5 in Hollywood, the location of the dot-com industry in the Silicon Valley, and the hub of the universe of modern rock and roll music. Yes, I'm California dreamin', that's the place for me, the mamas and the papas. Considering California's weather and opportunities, one would intuitively think its diverse economy would be a haven for those seeking their slice of the American pie. Despite its abundance of tree huggers, global warmers, tinfoil hatters, and anti-capitalistic progressives, it maintains many of the amenities that induced past thrill seekers to plunge into its Pacific waters. Although many of its famed allurements in the music, movie, and TV industries have self-destructed, it still has sunny beaches, shovel-ready jobs, its tech industries, and a populace in need of services. Yet people are fleeing California faster than a thief can steal an FM stereo in the parking lot at an El Monte Legion Stadium oldies concert. 40 years of liberal politics have confiscated the California dream. Larry Wood. Given its iconic past, the idea that more wage earners are leaving California than entering it breaches its former uniqueness and promise. Census Bureau data validates that businesses and middle-class families are escaping California's liberalism faster than Houdini could a straitjacket. This progressive state is facing an epic shortage of trained workers and business start UPS. Imported unskilled labor lured by a lucrative welfare system has turned capitalism into quasi-socialism. New cottage industries have replaced real businesses, and economic cleavage between the haves and have-to-depends wreaks havoc on the mostly highly taxed state in the U.S. Liberalism has turned all prosperity into poverty. The